I can hand up the mic to you now and you can get started. Thank you.
Sure. Hello and welcome, professors, to my thesis defense. My thesis research is titled as Advanced Non-Orthogonal and Deep Learning-Based Communication Techniques for Future Wireless Communication Systems. In the second slide, I will just give a brief outline of my presentation. My presentation will be divided into two parts, where I will be discussing my first contribution on the design of an advanced non-orthogonal multiple access security technique for future wireless communication system. This technique will be based on providing security against both internal and external eavesdroppers. Dropping. And in my second work, we will be providing an analysis on the implementation of deep learning for channel estimation and signal detection in OFDM systems. So starting with the need for secure communication, in Industrial Revolution 4.0, such as smart cities, using IoT devices for the communication and security of data, but it still suffers from security issues, such as an eavesdropper can hear sensitive information, a spoofer can manipulate the data or information or the communication, and it can cause mishaps. And a jammer can disrupt an undergoing communication between vehicle and infrastructure, and this can eventually cause mishaps and also severe accidents and several other security issues that can be misrupted by the eavesdropper. So in this work, we have designed a new security technique that can provide solutions to all these security issues existing in a smart city and that can solve issues in the future low complexity IoT devices. So just a brief introduction about the conventional solutions that are used for the security and of communication. So the conventional methods that are being used are based on cryptography. But from the research and from the results generated by the researchers, it has been proved that cryptography-based solutions, they are not suitable for future communication systems, low complexity. This is because of the heterogeneous nature of the future communication, where the key sharing and management might be very difficult, where cryptography-based solutions requires key sharing. So the key sharing, also it has been proved that the key sharing and cryptography-based encoders, encrypted data, they can also be decrypted and decoded by an eavesdropper. So these solutions might not be suitable for the future low complexity, low power consuming IoT devices. So in order to cater this drawback of cryptography based solutions, the physical layer security has achieved much attention. It has achieved much attention due to its great features, where it can extract the channel characteristics such as noise, such as fading, randomness, and much more. So physical layer security has much potential, and it is the future of securing the communication in wireless communication. So coming towards the motivation behind this work, we are motivated from the promising features that non-orthogonal multiple access scheme can provide. It can provide high spectral efficiency, low latency, improved coverage, massive connectivity, fairness, and so on. So just a pre-illustration of the conventional power domain NOMA. The figure illustrates the conventional power domain NOMA. I will just explain the working of this power domain NOMA in downlink scenario where a certain power level is being assigned to user 1 and user 2. In this situation, user 2 has more power assigned to it. So how it works? The conventional power domain NOMA works like user 1 first decodes the information or data or the signal from user 2, and it subtracts the total signal from user 2 signal and then gets its own signal. So, and the user 2 decodes its information directly. So you can see that there is power sharing, and this process of like subtraction of user 2's data from the total data, it is like called successive interference cancellation. Here you can see that there is a sharing of data between the two users, and there is a chance of eavesdropping where user 1 can hear user 2's sensitive information. So this successive interference cancellation process might create some internal eavesdropping. So coming towards the limitations in the conventional domain power, the conventional NOMA, the existing physical layer security schemes for NOMA, they are either limited to the case of external eavesdropping, because I explained that internal eavesdropping is all possible in conventional power domain NOMA, or it is based on cryptographic based approaches that require key sharing, high processing, high computational, and it does not make it suitable for the low complexity IoT devices, because cryptography based solutions require too much processing. Also, the conventional power domain NOMA suffers from performance degradation, such as the use of successive interference cancellation at the receiver and channel estimation errors, and the power sharing among the multiple users cause degradation in signal to interference noise power ratio. So also, the conventional power domain NOMA was adopted under the name of multiple user superposition transmission in the release 13 of 3GPP Global Partnership Project, and in for the downlink transmission of two users. But in recent release 17, NOMA was not adopted because of its lacking performance, as explained in the previous slide. So motivated by these drawbacks and the capability of NOMA that it can provide too much potential for the security of low complex devices, we are motivated to invent a new kind of NOMA scheme that can solve the problems that are existing in the conventional power domain NOMA and which was not adopted in the standard. So coming towards the proposed system, in the proposed system, we consider a scenario. We are considering a wireless system in which we have one transmitter and two receivers. So it's a multi-user communication system, and those under the risk of eavesdropping. So our goal here is to design a system that is robust against these security issues. And in the meanwhile, we ensure that the signals we transmit are totally secured, even by the internal network also. By internal network, I mean that the user 1 cannot hear the information of user 2. Neither the user 2 can hear the information of user 1. So they are not able to hear each other's information and decode each other's information. So the data vector or the data sequence of user one is represented here by U1 and U2. And the bits, or you can say the streams of each one, goes through a modulator such as like BPSK, QPSK, or QAM. We use BPSK for the simulations that will be disclosed in the upcoming slides. And first the data is converted in from serial to parallel, so it can become a vector, like a column vector, basically. So the most interesting invention, so the most interaction is interesting contribution is in the devising of the pre-coding matrices. The solutions that these pre-coding matrices can provide is that it ensures 100% security and secrecy of the data. Also, it avoids the interference between the users. Also, it avoids the successive interference cancellation at the users, because we want to shift all the complexity to the base station rather than at the receiver. So it can be used in low complexity IoT devices, and there is no complexity at receiver side. We ensured that this pre-coder matrices will ensure this. And why we are calling it non-orthogonal? We are calling it like in non-orthogonal because we are superimposing the two users. We are intentionally like introducing interference by putting user one and user two data streams on top of each other. And we designed the pre-coder's matrices intelligently in such a way when our signal passes through the channel, they get separated at the receiver and we receive it successfully whatsoever. So you can say that by introducing this kind of system model, we are introducing a new kind of new degree of freedom by having another transmit antenna. This antenna is basically, the second antenna is basically to provide antenna diversity, and it is transmitting the same antenna as antenna one. These antennas simultaneously transmit the data. Or you can also say that it is non-diversity technique because there are separate pre-coders used for transmitting the data from the second antenna. So the novelty behind this system model can be summarized in a few couple of points. Like, it does not require successive interference cancellation like the conventional power domain NOMA, and there is simultaneous transmission of two users' data. Data is superimposed with the pre-coding matrices that are especially channel-based dependent pre-coder matrices. And it provides security against internal and external eavesdropping. And it is very much suitable and has too much capability to be used in 5G and beyond communication systems or IoT devices. Here is a comparison of the conventional power domain NOMA and the proposed design. Like, you can see that the conventional NOMA uses successive interference cancellation, and we provide through antenna diversity, and we provide the simultaneous transmission of data from two antennas simultaneously. And this does not require successive interference cancellation because it is automatic interference cancellation when the data is transmitted from two antennas simultaneously. So that's the difference between our proposed NOMA, and that provides an edge over the conventional NOMA. Coming towards the proposed algorithm, as you can see, this is a like compact picture of the proposed model and the transmitting data and the receiving side. So the superimposed transmitted signal from antenna 1 can be given as follows, where X1 is the transmitted data in the frequency domain, which is superimposed with the respective from, this is the transmitted data from user 1 basically in the frequency domain, which is superimposed with the with its respective precoder. And similarly, this is the transmitted data from user 2, and it is also superimposed with its respective precoder and transmitted from antenna 1. And simultaneously, at the same time, the data X1 and X2, these are same data but different precoders using antenna diversity. So X1 from the second antenna, from the second antenna is superimposed with its respective precoder, and simultaneously these signals are transmitted from both the antennas. So the goals are summarized as providing security against internal eavesdropping, security against external eavesdropping, and security for low processing devices. So yes, just like illustration of the superposition, X1 superimposed with M1A, similarly X2 superimposed with X2A, and like this from two antennas, antenna 1, antenna 2. Now these are the equations of the received signal at received signal from user 1 at user 1 and user 2 from antenna 1 and antenna 2. Here H is the channel between the Y is the received signal from antenna 1 at user 1. Similarly, Y21 is the received signal from antenna 2 at user 1, and this is the respective channel, and this is the transmitted data. Similarly, for user 2, this is the equation for the received signal at user 1 from antenna 2, received signal at user 2 from antenna 2, and similarly, both equations are designed. Eavesdropper is also receiving some degraded information, and and it can be, the equation can be written as follows, designed in the same manner as for user 1 and user 2. Coming towards the combined received signal at user 1 and user 2, The combined received signal from antenna 1 and antenna 2 at both the users can be given as, where both the equations from first antenna and second antenna, they are combined. So they are given as follows. We should note that similarly for equation user 2, it is given as follows, the combined equation. We have combined the equations from, as mentioned from in the previous slide, and similarly for the eavesdropper. It is important to note here that user 1, the first term is desired term, while the second term is interference term. X1 is basically the desired term for user 1, and for user 2, the X2 term is desired while the first term is interference, and for eavesdropper, both the terms are desired for it. It is important to note here that we have not added the noise while calculating while doing mathematical calculations, because the noise while doing the mathematical calculations does not affect the results and does not affect the design of precoders. So, but while doing the simulations, of course, we need to consider the noise also. So coming towards the main part, that is the design of precoder matrices. coming towards the design of pre-coder matrices, we considered the desired term of user one as identity matrix, and the interference term of user two as zero. So similarly, for the design of other sets of pre-coder matrices for M2A and M2B, we considered the second term, that is the desired term, as identity matrix, and the non-desired term of user one as the interference. It is important to note here that we represent the vectors with the small bold letters, and we denote the matrices with the capital bold letters. So solving these equations jointly for M1A and M1B and for M2A and M2B, we get the pre-coder matrices M1A, M1B, M2A and M2B. So these are the basically the values of the pre-coders based on all the calculations and mathematical analysis. So when we plug these pre-coder values or matrices at the transmitter side during the transmitter process, we get zero interference from user one and user two, and similar for user two and user one. And eavesdropper will also not be able to hear any of the user's data. So this is an amazing, the main intelligence lies in the design of pre-coder matrices. So analyzing the performance of the proposed algorithm, based the signal to interference noise ratio at eavesdropper for eavesdropping the information intended for user one is given as follows. And for eavesdropper for eavesdropping the information intended for user two is given as follows, where all the terms are explained before. H is the channel between channel, X is the data of user one in frequency domain, and this is the noise variance. So it is clear from the equations that there is a clear degradation in the performance of eavesdroppers. So this kind of proves our algorithm mathematically, that it can provide approximately perfect secrecy from the eavesdroppers. So a brief summary of what advantages does this proposed algorithm offer. It provides security against external eavesdropping. It provides security against internal eavesdropping. It is less complex because of the diagonal channel matrix and the inverse operation. It is more simple, and the pre-coder matrices can be designed by a simple computation, and it does not require too much processing as explained in the system model. So it also requires limited processing because there is no need of interference cancellation, unlike the conventional power domain NOMA. And it enhances the complexity for the eavesdroppers because of the channel-based pre-coder signals of the two users and data transmitted simultaneously from two antenna. It is more challenging for the eavesdropper compared to the channel adaptive secure transmission based on single user. So proving the robustness of our proposed algorithm via simulation analysis. the green and blue lines represent the performance of legitimate user one and user two, the bit error rate performance versus SNR performance of legitimate user one and user two. While EE1, EE2 represents the performance of external eavesdroppers, and IE1 and IE2 represents the performance of internal eavesdroppers, that user one is trying to eavesdrop from user two and user two from user one. So it is clear that there is like the performance of the eavesdroppers is very much degraded, and it's somewhat approx to near to zero. And there is clear difference between both the users' performances. So this proves the robustness of our proposed algorithm. Similarly, coming towards the throughput perform versus SNR performance for the proposed algorithm, again, it is clear from the figure that user one, user two employing the proposed algorithm have much difference between the performance of eavesdroppers and the performance of authorized user one and user two. This again kind of proves the performance of a proved a proposed algorithm that it is suitable for providing secure and reliable communication. Coming towards the peak to average power ratio performance of conventional FTM and proposed algorithm. Yes. So here you can see the more nearer to the y-axis, the more better the performance. The performance of the proposed algorithm outperforms the performance of the conventional OFDM. Here the CCDF denotes complementary cumulative distribution function. And why we get this improved performance? We get this improved performance because the precoder matrices, when designed at the transmitter, they change the distribution of signal from being Gaussian to something less random than Gaussian, or we can say close to uniform. So that's the reason our proposed algorithm provides better peak to average power ratio, and it is really great that we get such amazing result. So we also test our proposed algorithm in case for for imperfect channel cases. What we did here is that we added an intentional error, which can be denoted as delta H in the true channel. And the imperfect channel is like given as delta H. Here, as you can see, that is the variance of the error. The red line denotes that there is zero variance error. And as we increase the error, the bit error rate degrades more and more. So this proves the robustness of our proposed algorithm once again. Coming towards the second part of the work where we have implemented deep learning on OFDM system for the channel estimation and signal detection. The main novelty of this work is that without using the channel state information explicitly and without using complex waveforms and like demodulation, we can do all the things with deep learning. And here we have like investigated the pros and cons of using deep learning in OFDM communication systems. So just a brief introduction about the OFDM system. OFDM is called orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, is a multi-carrier wideband digital communication system. It is used in modern communication systems such as cellular 5G, wireless network, mobile power line networks, DSL, and smart TV. So why do we do channel estimation in OFDM systems? We do the channel estimation to design an efficient receiver. And to design an efficient receiver, you must have the knowledge of the channel properties, because the channel causes effects such as fading, interference, Doppler, and etc. And to cancel these impairments, a receiver needs to know the channel. And once the receiver have these knowledge, it can improve the impairments caused by the channel. So that's why channel estimation is important for OFDM systems. Coming towards the conventional techniques that are used for the channel estimation in OFDM system, this is the channel between the transmitter and the receiver. The conventional techniques require channel state information explicitly, and in our proposed technique we are using it implicitly, and the other properties of these conventional techniques are that it takes into account the least square method takes into account the noise, its performance. That's why its performance may be degraded or inadequate. While minimum mean square error, it reduces the noise enhancement by regulating the noise, and it leads to much better performance than the least square method. So now the novelty in the proposed deep learning based system. We have used the DNN structure at the receiver side, and it is different from the OFDM receivers, the conventional OFDM receivers. The baseband of the conventional of the system is quite similar to the conventional system, but we have made some we have introduced deep learning and we have introduced deep learning at the receiver side just to test that how it can affect the OFDM communication system. So we used offline training and online deployment. First, the model is trained offline with the received OFDM samples, and the samples are from different diverse conditions with certain statistical properties such as typical urban or hilly terrain profile. While in the online deployment, the deep neural network model generates output and recovers the transmitted data, explicitly estimating the wireless channel. The difference lies here from the conventional OFDM. The model training parameters, we have used a 5-layered model where 3 layers are the hidden layers, and the numbers of neurons in each layer are as follows. In every 16 bits of the transmitted data are grouped and predicted based on a single model trained independently, which is then concatenated for the final input. While the ReLU function is used as the activation function in most layers, except in the last layer where sigmoid function is applied to map the output to the interval. So for the simulation parameters, we have used the subcarriers, carrier frequency, cyclic preference, delay, and modulation type as QPSK. Coming towards the pilot's effect, this is a comparison between the deep learning method with conventional method using 8 and 64 pilots. So as can be seen from the figures, first I will like to just go through the performance of 8 pilots. You can see that the performance of when less pilots are used, the deep learning method outperforms the conventional least square and minimum mean square method. This is because the reason for this superior performance of DNN is that the channel state information is not uniformly distributed, unlike the conventional least square mean square method. The characteristics of the channel can be learned from the training data generated from the model. We have already trained the OFDM samples with different channel characteristics. Though it is, I think, not possible in the real life scenario, because or maybe it is possible in the real life scenario because like it is possible in a closed place, like in an office or in a building. But if you are traveling in a car and traveling very fast, then if you train the model online, then it will pass through so many randomness, and it will be very difficult to design such a system. So that's why the performance here is better than the conventional methods, because we have used the online training where the static data has been used, static characteristics of the channel has been used. While when the higher pilots are used, like 64 pilots, the minimum mean square method is better than the deep learning method, but still the performance is better than the least square method. So here we can draw the conclusion that deep learning can be implemented when less number of pilots are provided, and like there is a large number of pilots, then we can use minimum mean square method. This is just an analysis. This is the results based on our analysis. So coming towards our another result, we're based on the effect of cyclic prefix, where we have compared the performance of proposed deep learning technique in OFDM and conventional method with and without cyclic prefix. Here we have got some really amazing results. Like deep learning is providing better results even with and without cyclic prefix, and it outperforms both the minimum mean square and least square method. The reason for its outstanding performance is again, I think, the same, because we are considering an offline system where the channel characteristics are static. If we consider it in the real life scenario, then the channel characteristics will be random, and it is very difficult to train the model. Even the research is still being going on. It is very difficult to use deep neural network in the wireless system, because in image processing and like computer vision, we already have the images that are trained, but here that can be trained. That's why it's super successful in those domains. But in wireless communication, it has not been that successful that it can be adopted in current era. Maybe it will be adopted in the upcoming 5G plus or like 6G. So coming towards the conclusion and future work of our first work based on NOMA security, in that work we have designed an efficient technique for the reliable and secure communication, and which is very much suitable for low complexity IoT devices, channel dependent precoders using simultaneous transmission using antenna diversity approach is proposed to ensure reliable and secure communication against both internal and external eavesdropping. And we have proved our algorithm through simulation results. And in the future, we are working on the extension of the proposed algorithm for multiple base stations. The MATLAB simulation course can be found at researcherstore.com. Coming towards the conclusion of the future work for deep learning based OFDM system. Since the deep learning based approach is effective in critical situations like harmful wireless channel, there are high distortion and interference. It is important for deep learning based techniques in the real world to have a strong generalization ability. Yes, and concerning the channel model parameters so that it can still work effectively when online deployment conditions are not exactly correct. So in the future work, we are working to investigate the performance of our first work, Noma Security with Deep Learning Based Communication System. And the MATLAB simulation codes of this work can also be found at simulation codes. The part of this work was presented at SoftCom 2020 conference organized by University of Split in Croatia. And extended journal version of this work can be read from RS Open Journal or Innovation Communication Technologies. Thank you for your patience.